Are you looking for an ultra-wide gaming monitor? In this video, I will show you the best ultra-wide gaming monitors based on my personal opinion and hours of research. If you want more information and updated pricing on the products mentioned, be sure to check the links in the description down below. The sixth product on the list is the Gigabyte G34WQC. The best ultra-wide gaming monitor in the budget category that we've tested is the Gigabyte G34WQC. This 34-inch monitor has a 21:9 aspect ratio that provides an excellent immersive gaming experience, and it's also great for multitasking with multiple windows. Thanks to its great contrast ratio, it produces deep blacks, making it an ideal option for dark rooms. It handles reflections well, and it gets bright enough to combat glare, so you shouldn't have any visibility issues in well-lit rooms. It has an outstandingly low input lag, fast response time, and 144Hz refresh rate, delivering smooth and responsive gameplay. Also, it supports Freesync natively to reduce screen tearing. It's compatible with GSYNC as well, but it only works over a DisplayPort connection. It also has an optional black frame insertion feature to improve motion clarity, but it causes some slight image duplication, and it can't be used while VRR is active. Unfortunately, it has disappointingly narrow viewing angles that cause images to look washed out when viewed from the side, which isn't ideal if you plan to play co-op with someone sitting next to you. While its HDR peak brightness is consistent and decent enough for gaming, it isn't bright enough for HDR movies. Nonetheless, this monitor has many good features, and it's a great budget gaming option if you want an immersive and responsive experience. The fifth product on the list is the LG 29UM69GB. If you find the Gigabyte G34WQC too big, then check out the LG 29UM69GB. It's a very different monitor, as it has a 29-inch IPS panel, a 1080p resolution, and its refresh rate is limited to 75Hz. Its IPS panel does come with a few benefits, such as wider viewing angles and better accuracy out of the box. It has good response time, FreeSync support, and GSYNC compatibility. Unfortunately, it has a low contrast ratio that makes it less ideal for dark rooms, and it doesn't get very bright, so it might have trouble fighting glare. Also, it doesn't support HDR. On the upside, it has a USB-C port that supports DisplayPort Alt mode, which lets you display an image from a compatible device and charge it at the same time. If you can afford it, the Gigabyte is a much better choice, as it's a significant step up from the LG performance-wise, and the price increase is well worth it. However, if your space is limited, the LG is a pretty decent alternative. The fourth product on the list is the Samsung C49RG9. The best super ultra-wide gaming monitor we've tested is the Samsung C49RG9. It has a massive 49-inch screen, with a 32:9 aspect ratio that spans nearly your entire field of view, delivering a stunning and immersive gaming experience. It's basically the same as running two 27-inch 16:9 monitors side by side, but without any distracting bezels in between. Images and text look sharp thanks to its 1440p resolution, and it has an excellent peak brightness that makes it suitable for use in any lighting conditions. It has a great response time and a 120Hz refresh rate that makes motion look incredibly smooth. It supports FreeSync to help minimize screen tearing, however, it isn't compatible with NVIDIA's GSYNC. Input lag is extremely low and only rises a bit when playing with 10-bit HDR. Although it only supports HDR10, it delivers an experience that's far above most HDR-capable monitors that we've tested. It can display a wide color gamut and gets very bright, enough to make highlights pop in HDR movies. There are four USB ports that you can use to charge your mobile devices, and some LED lighting on the back. There's a picture-in-picture mode that lets you display images from two input sources at once, which can be a useful feature for streamers using a separate computer to stream. All in all, it's a great super ultra-wide gaming monitor that should satisfy most gamers, provided that you have enough desk space. The third product on the list is the Acer Nitro 15340CK. The best ultra-wide gaming monitor we've tested is the Acer Nitro 15340CK. It's a 34-inch monitor with a 21:9 aspect ratio, and surprisingly, it doesn't have a curved screen. It's decently built and has good ergonomics for an ultra-wide, with a full 360-degree swivel range. It also has decent viewing angles, making it a good option for playing co-op games. It handles reflections well but doesn't get very bright, so it's better suited for a dark to moderately lit room. It has a fast response time to deliver clear images in fast-moving scenes, and a black frame insertion feature to further improve motion clarity. Its 144Hz refresh rate keeps motion looking very smooth, and it supports Freesync to minimize screen tearing. It's compatible with NVIDIA's GSYNC as well, but only over a DisplayPort connection. There's HDR support, and playing in HDR doesn't add any noticeable input lag. That said, the HDR experience is rather disappointing, as it can't display a wide color gamut and doesn't get bright enough. It has a pair of integrated speakers, two USB 3.0 ports, and a picture-in-picture mode that lets you display images from two input sources simultaneously. All in all, it's an impressive gaming monitor that should satisfy most gamers. The second product on the list is the Alienware AW3420DW. If you have an NVIDIA graphics card and prefer a monitor that supports GSYNC natively, consider the Dell Alienware. Its size and aspect ratio are the same as the Acer Nitro, but it has a curved screen. It has an excellent refresh rate and a quick response time, however, it has a lot of overshoot. The Dell has an outstandingly low input lag, and while it's slightly higher than that the Acer, the difference shouldn't be too noticeable. Unfortunately, it doesn't support HDR, and blacks don't look as deep due to the lower contrast ratio. Also, its reflection handling is only mediocre, so you may struggle to see the screen well if you're in a bright room. If you want a higher refresh rate, get the Acer, but if you want native GSYNC support, which is better for NVIDIA graphic cards, go with the Dell. The first product on the list is the Acer Predator Z35P. If you find yourself gaming in a dark room often, check out the Acer Predator Z35P. While its lower peak brightness makes it less ideal for a bright room, it has a VA panel that can produce deep blacks, making it the better choice for dark rooms than the Acer Nitro or the Dell Alienware. It has an amazing response time and an outstandingly low input lag, which should provide a fast and responsive gaming experience. It also supports GSYNC, which prevents screen tearing, but it's only supported over DisplayPort. Unfortunately, its viewing angles are disappointing, which isn't ideal if you plan on playing co-op with someone sitting beside you. If you want a higher refresh rate and a higher peak brightness, go with the Dell, but if you tend to game in the dark most often, the Acer might be a better choice. Thanks for watching this video. Please leave a like if this helped you out, and if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. Subscribe for more content, and I hope to see you next time.